In this video, I'm going to share my screen again to show you what the Skilled Worker Visa UK is, the professions that are included, the list of employers, the list of companies that are currently recruiting, and where you can find every information that you need about this visa. Linda Eze here. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, welcome. And to my returning subscribers, thank you so much for your support. I am very happy to also share my screen today to show how the Skilled Worker Visa work, where you find the information that you need, the professions that are included, how to get a job, how to apply, and everything that you need to know about this visa. If you find this information valuable, please like and subscribe to this channel, share with someone that actually needs this information, and always come back for more. Thank you so much, and let's go.
We are going to be talking about the Skilled Worker Visa. This is now for those, include those that are not in the healthcare, because I've been getting a lot of questions. How about those that are not in healthcare? Can they apply for a job? Fortunately, yes, they can. You just have to follow the rules. I just believe that if you follow the rules and get a job, then you are more confident in whatever you're doing, while you live in the UK, you're more confident, okay? So now we are going to go through this visa. Just type Skilled Worker Visa UK. This is the official website. So what is this, the overview, the job, the course? We are going to look at the course as well, whether the jobs that are accepted, the list of employers that can actually sponsor you. That is where you can be looking out for jobs, whether they are able to give you a certificate of sponsorship and everything, okay? Let's begin. Okay, so this a Skilled Worker Visa allows you to come to or stay in the UK to do an eligible job with an approved employer. So this visa has replaced, the one I came with was Tier 2 visa. Now it is called the Skilled Worker Visa. So from this year, from December, I think, the visa is now Skilled Worker Visa. So yeah, so this is what it is about. So this is actually, if you get a job with an approved employer, then you can get this deal and you can get this Skilled Worker Visa, okay? So the eligibility, you have to qualify, you must work for an employer that has been approved by the Home Office. So it's not just anybody, okay? They must be approved by the Home Office and they are able to give a certificate of sponsorship. But there is something good about this. If you apply for a job in the UK and you get any job at all, but the employer is not approved, that employer can actually pay to be approved. They are supposed to pay, apply, and then they will be issued, they will be allowed to start recruiting internationally. So if you get a job and they are not approved, that employer can actually apply to be part of the employer that can give certificates of sponsorship. So that is very good, okay? You also need an English requirement. But this English requirement, sometimes it might not be like so rigid. So that one should not be a problem for you. Then, how long did this visa last? It lasts up to 5 years and you can renew it as far as you remain in an employment that is qualified. Then how to apply? You have to be outside of the UK to apply. If you're in the UK and you already have a visa, you may need to update it and or also change to this particular visa for you to take up any employment. It's not a complicated process. If you get, if you're already in the UK and you get a job and you don't have this visa, that employer will even, their human resources will advise you on what to do, okay? So how long it takes, he said you can apply for a visa up to 3 months before the day you are due to start your job. Then getting a decision within 3 weeks, you may get it. It can even be faster or it can be more. Then how much it costs, you can, let's go to how much it costs so you can see it here. So if anybody's helping you, you know exactly what it's up. So you can pay a standard application fee of £610 to £1,408. You have to pay a health surcharge. This is usually £624 per year. Then you'll be able to support yourself. You have something like £1,200 in your bank account that you can use to support yourself. So if you have all of these, then you are almost good to go. You have the application fee and then One thing I want to mention is that for this skilled worker visa, there, if you are in healthcare, then you might be able to, it will have to be the health and care worker visa. They are also skilled worker visa, but they have a separate visa for healthcare workers. So I just, if you just met this video, this is actually a continuation of the last one because I didn't want it to be too long. So if it is the health, if you are looking for a job in health and care, this in the health and care sector, just watch that first one, okay? So this is for every other person, okay? So yeah, this is that. So the next one is the documents that you need to apply for this. So for the document, you will need a certificate of sponsorship. That is, you have to look for a job and find one. Proof of English, usually the proof of English is the IELTS, International English Language Testing System, I think. I'm not sure if that's correct now, but it's IELTS. If you go online, British Council, you'll find it. So, and then if you need a certificate of sponsorship, your employer should be able to provide that. Then other documents that you may be able to need, savings, proof of relationship with your children, because in this visa you can move with your family, so you have to have documents to show that you are actually they are actually your partner or your children. Then you have, you need to do a TB test as well. You need to have a valid certificate. So now, if you are eligible, just pay attention. If you are eligible, one thing you have to understand is, depending on your skills, depending on the sector, on the skill that you are applying to, you have to find out if that skill is regulated. If it is for healthcare workers, definitely is regulated. So if it is regulated, you try, if you see, okay, yes, I'm qualified for this visa, then you have to find out how you can also register with that particular body. Then you can now continue looking for job and everything. Jobs that are actually included in this skilled worker visa that you can apply for, you can just Google the UK shortage occupation list. Shortage occupation list. Yeah. Okay. So the UK shortage occupation list is here. So this will give you an idea whether you are actually, so you have the health services, of course, like I mentioned, you have the residential day and the necessary care. They need all these chemical scientists, biological scientists, physical scientists. You just go through social media. It's actually by civil engineers, all the different areas of engineering, electrical, mechanical, electronic design and development, engineer production and processing. IT is a big one. Architect and system design, all jobs like veterinarians, whatever. Architects, quality control, you see, they need a lot of, the main thing is that if you can actually prove that you have a certificate, you have the necessary registration, and you are in this sector, then you go ahead and start applying for a job. If it is not a regulated sector, I'm not sure if the civil engineers and everything, they have regulations or stuff, but even if they need that, one thing I want to mention is that even if they need regulation, when you apply for a job, they will let you know. That's how, don't be scared to say, oh, I don't know whether they are regulated or something like that. First of all, apply. It's, you don't expect, okay, immediately, okay, they will welcome you and say, oh, come. They will tell you the requirement. If they look at your CV and say, you don't have this one, they say, oh, you need to be registered with, you need to be registered with health and social care, you need to be registered with engineering council. Then you know that there's a body like that. Then you can even ask them, okay, do you have such a body? How can I contact them? Sometimes they will not even allow you to start asking that. They will say, just tell you, they will just refer you to the website where you need to go and complete the necessary registration, because it is also on those employers to make sure that the people that they are employing, they have the necessary requirements, okay? So if your job, if your certificate is in any of these categories, please, please go ahead and look for a job. And there are lists of approved workers. That's one thing again. Do not allow anybody to take your money for anything. Anybody that is telling you to come for a job or anything, make sure you verify in the UK government that these people are actually legal and these people are actually registered. Or, as I mentioned, if they are not registered, you ask them, I am aware that you need to be registered with these people. If you really need it to work for you, then you need to apply for this so that you'll be eligible to provide the certificate of sponsorship. Please don't waste your money for, as you are, other people are helping you, or you're helping yourself, it's good for you to be on in the know. It's good for you to know exactly what you are doing, okay? So they have like register, I downloaded it earlier. Okay, you have register of workers and temporary license sponsor. These people now are sponsored. You have the Architects Limited. Remember, we saw that the architects are also in the shortage of question list. The Stop Halal European. They have a lot. Just go through all of these people. The big ones like the Amazon, like you know, TFL, TSFL, sorry, that's drivers for UK, I can't remember the full meaning now, but drivers in the UK, they are lorry drivers and they are bus drivers, they are in high demand. Just go to all those major, usually, as I always mention, go to the government jobs, go to the government jobs that are in your field and look for jobs. They are the ones that you can get. You are almost more confident that if they do have vacancies, they are most likely to take you. So go to TFL, go to Amazon, go to all these known employers. Go towards them, follow them on LinkedIn, message them. Even if you don't have any, if they don't post any job, you can send them an email and ask them if they have vacancies. If they don't have, they tell you if they don't have. They do have the tell, just like I mentioned that I sent a couple of emails this morning asking them if they recruit, because I keep getting these messages about the recruitment, how it is done and everything. Even if I explain everything and you are still confused, the trick here, the secret here is to apply first. When you apply and you are not qualified, then they'll tell you, oh, we need this, and this. Then you have a roadmap, okay? Then you have a roadmap, and please always, always refer back to this UK website. In my own opinion, everything can be found in this website. Everything about this business can be found, like overview the job, how much you even need, the documents you need. So if anybody starting to pay one, like, you know, so you come back here, how much is actually cost? So if somebody is helping you, and the person that has fees, it will be in addition to this one, a little. Not something that you cannot, if you can afford it, fine. If you cannot afford it, you know. Then you can also ask your employer if they are able to help you. Some employers help with travels, accommodation, and everything. Okay, so please use this as a reference. Use this as a reference for everything, for the employers, whether they are registered, for jobs, for how much it costs, for what you need, for the documents you need. Come on, please go for this. Even if it is difficult, it seems difficult in the beginning, the secret to anything that people actually do and achieve is beginning the first step, taking the first step, taking the leap, sending that email. Just browse, not just browsing and sleeping or listening to me right now and saying, oh, this is too much, or is this happening, or can I actually do this? Take the first step, send the first email, organize your CV. As I always mention, go to perfectcv.com. Use that template, copy, put your own details and everything, make up your own CV the way it should, and go ahead and go for it, really. And I wish you the very, very best. Please like, subscribe, and share with someone. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.